Here's an example of what a Gradle build script looks like. Even without any explanation, it's reasonably easy to figure out what's going on. We have what kind of looks like a stripped-down JSON syntax. However, down here, where it looks like we're creating a task, there's what looks like a Java println statement. What's going on here? Is this script just structured data like JSON or XML? Or is this actual Java code? Well, the answer is that Gradle scripts are written in a special purpose build language provided by Gradle. But it's not a language that was developed from scratch. It sits on top of a generic scripting language called Groovy. Groovy has a lot of syntactic sugar and other features that allow us to write build scripts that look a lot more like natural language when compared to using something like Java. Second, Groovy integrates perfectly with Java, which is the language that Gradle platform is written in. The main thing you need to learn when using Gradle is the Gradle build language, which is where the keywords like Android and task are coming from. But it also helps a lot to understand how this build language sits on top of Groovy and Java. The entire build script has what we call a delegate object, which exposes the Gradle build language to Groovy scripting language within the build script. If you write a Gradle plugin, you could write it in any language and use the same delegate object. The Gradle build language is also called the Gradle Dsl, or domain-specific language. A domain-specific language is a language that is finely tailored for a specific task. In this case, the domain we're talking about is an Android build. Note, there's a big difference between describing your build and providing explicit instructions on how to actually make the build happen. The Gradle Dsl is declarative, so you're only responsible for describing your build, and Gradle itself knows how to make it happen. That means your build scripts can be much shorter and much easier to understand. However, within the build script, you have a full-blown, powerful programming language at your disposal. We do recommend that you keep build scripts declarative and try not to pollute it with low-level logic. That's what Gradle plugins are for. You can write them in any JVM language like Java, Groovy, or Scala.